got today is the Hoyt VTM in the 31 inch axle to axle. This is in the bourbon riser with the sub alpine limbs along with the quiver to go with that. Now, I'm not fully set up. I'm currently waiting on the carbon go sticks that attach here at the bottom that folds out as a bipod. And I'm waiting on a 8-inch stabilizer and a 6-inch for my front and back setup. But the VTM comes with this short, what I call the stubby stabilizer. So it comes with this. But overall, it is a beautiful, beautiful looking bow. It's amazing shooting bow, quiet, dead in the hand. So I got out here today and I put some orange accents on it. But we're gonna send some shots right over my shoulder here. I've got two targets set up, one at about 20, one at about 30. And which I transferred my sight from my Hoyt Torx onto this bow. So it's not completely dialed in yet, but it's close enough to the point where I can send some shots downrange. And I'll let y'all get a feel for what it sounds like, what it feels like. But overall, right now, it's a little front heavy. If I hold it out here, it's wanting to dip down to the front just a little bit, but that's where the back bar comes in handy. So I'm waiting on it, but it's got a quick little just dial right here. Loosen it up, slide the quiver on and off that way. And then this quiver is carbon, so it is super light. It does not weigh anything, but this is the 2023 Hoyt VTM in the 31 inch axle to axle. All right guys, so we are lined up here. We are shooting this front target first. We are at about 20, 22 yards right now. So I've got a whole shebang of arrows. All these arrows are a little bit different. They're not my hunting arrows, they're just old arrows I had laying around the house. But I'll draw back and give y'all my initial thoughts on the drawback, draw cycle, let off, shot, feel, steadiness, all that. So I'll move that chair out of the way a little bit and I'll draw it back and we'll get a taste for how this bow feels. So instantly, there's a little initial resistance when you go to draw back. But once you're back there, it feels like dead weight. I'm pulling back 70 pounds, about a 27, 27 and a half inch draw. And it feels, feels like dead weight. Once you get back to that full draw, it does not feel like you're holding back 70 pounds at all. Definitely, I could see myself definitely, if I had to stay full draw for a couple minutes maybe, I could definitely see myself not having an issue with that, although I'm pulling back 70 pounds. But I do have the 60, 70 pound limbs on this bow. There's a 50 to 60, 60 to 70, and 70 to 80. I'm rocking the 60 to 70, but I'll draw back one more time, just kind of let y'all see the draw cycle on it again. Hopefully y'all can see that pretty good in the camera right there. And I'll send the shot down range. So I don't know how well y'all can hear it. It's raining a little bit out here, but super, super quiet. Very, very smooth in the hand. Overall, amazing, amazing shooting bow. This is their, the VTM is their aluminum flagship bow for 2023. So it is on the pricey side. But the VTM will fall a little under the carbon RX-7, which obviously carbon is more expensive. But the VTM is a little heavy when it's fully decked out. But personally, it's not too heavy for me. It's still really, it feels great in the hand, and obviously it feels amazing shooting. So I'll send another shot down range real quick and see if y'all can hear it okay, and watch that draw cycle again. So one thing I mainly notice is when I draw back, the back wall on it is amazing. There's no sponge to it at all. Once you're back there, you're set. And it's got a very firm back wall. And I'll draw back again, and I'll let y'all see that back wall real quick. I'll get up here a little bit closer for y'all, hopefully. Maybe y'all can see it better. But so once you're back here, I mean, like, pulling back a little bit, like, there's very, I'll get back here where you can see it, there is very little sponge there. So it's got a really firm back wall, and I really like that aspect of it. But overall, like I said, it feels amazing in the hand, amazing shooting bow. So I'm going to get a couple different angles and let y'all see it from all sides while I send some shots downrange. Alright guys, so I looked up the specs just to make sure I've got everything correct for you all. The ATA on this bow is 342 feet per second. Now obviously, a lot of your hunting setups, you're not going to be able to get that speed out of it. But with the setup I'm running right now, I'm shooting at a very high speed with a 70 pound draw. So you're definitely getting a lot of speed, and based off your arrow setup, a lot of penetration with this bow. The brace height is 6 inches. Like I said, you can get the limbs from 50 to 60, 60 to 70, 70 to 80. It is a 31 inch axle to axle, obviously, by the name. This does come with a 34 inch as well. I prefer the 31 just because I'm relatively an average size guy. I'm not very big. So to me, I like a smaller bow, shorter bow. So this is where I like that 31 instead of the 34, but unbelievable, unbelievable shooting bow. Absolutely love it. I'm pretty sure the your draw length ranges from 25 inches all the way to 30 inches. So you've got quite a bit of room there to play around with. But as you can see here, like I said, it's a little front heavy right now, but just holding it out. Right now, I've not got any other fingers on it. I'm just bracing it with this, and I mean, the balance is really, really nice. But got a lot of different color options as well. Like I said, I've got the bourbon riser, I've got the sub alpine limbs with some orange accents on it. I'm running a trophy ridge one pin adjustable yardage sight, along with I'm shooting Easton 6.5 arrows in the 340 spine. My overall setup, I'm shooting 2-inch cut rage hypodermics. So my overall setup is about 433 grains. So I'm not too heavy, not too light, kind of right there in the middle, right there where I like to be. But if you run a lighter arrow, you could definitely get more speed out of this bow. But overall, I mean, I'm getting a lot of speed right now just with my setup. But overall, like I said, amazing shooting bow. I mean, absolutely amazing. I'm gonna go pull my arrows. I'll come back up here and we'll shoot a couple more. Alright guys, so this bow, the HOYT VTM 31, is incredibly quiet, incredibly fast, very dead in the hand. I love the grip on it. It's got a really nice grip on it. But I've got two or three pieces being custom ordered to ship to match the bow, but you've got some dampeners up here, dampeners. So the vibration on this thing is almost little to none when you shoot. There's hardly no vibration at all. The back wall is very firm, not a lot of sponge to it. I like that. It is quiet, it's quick, relatively heavy to for my liking, but like I said, I am running, I've got a heavier side on it, and I'm gonna be running two or three extra pieces of equipment on it once they get in here, but overall it is not bad at all. It is an amazing shooting bow, completely dead in the hand, very quiet, very fast, and honestly just a beautiful looking bow. So if you are able to spend the money to get a flagship bow, I highly recommend the HOYT VTM 31. I've shot some Matthews, I've shot some HOYTs, I've shot a Elite. So I've kind of been around, shot a little bit of everything, but obviously as you can tell, I chose the VTM as my next hunting bow. I don't really do a whole lot of tournament shooting, mainly just hunting. So I highly recommend this bow if you are able to spend the money. But no matter what y'all shoot, good luck to you all, and thank you all for watching.